day usually starts around 9:30, 10. I come into the office, say hello to everyone. Jason and I sort of assess what needs to be done for the week, whether it's production related or design related. Around 3:30, I usually leave for the day. Jason stays at the office and usually works for a couple more hours.
My day is usually over before I know it, and then try to go home and have dinner as a family. How do I keep my head from exploding with like all of the business happening, you know, with basically three businesses and two kids? One major thing for me is I take a motorcycle trip every year with all of my homies. We just get out, turn the phone off, and hit the open road, and we're on a motorcycle, and that like clears my mind, and it grounds me, and it makes me remember who I am and where I came from. And then I think the other thing that you have to think about, like, people can get really caught up in their career. You know, maybe they had a rough day, so then you're not like super engaged with their kids. What I always tell myself is that none of this really matters. The most important thing when we come home is our family. That's for me how I try to keep it in perspective. That and the occasional scotch.
Right. I prioritize family first above everything, even though obviously I'm a working mom and it's hard to find the time to cook and work and do everything else. I'm hanging out with the kids, I'm making dinner, and basically if I have to work, if it's been a stressful day or a long day and I have to work after I put them to bed, that's not a problem. I bring my laptop home and I do what I gotta do. When your kids are young, this is like a time in their life that you're never gonna have back, so you gotta enjoy it for what it is. I'm really inspired by textiles and color and prints and patterns. I really love the colors and just the culture of India. I grew up in Alhambra, which is sort of near Pasadena. Back, you know, when I first started, even though Jason wasn't like an official partner of the business, he used to help me like make tags and, you know, sew the labels onto the t-shirts.
Lived in Colorado, upstate New York, Texas, California. When I moved out to California, I got picked up by Santa Cruz basically and a few other sponsors and did that for a while. From skateboarding, I segued into photography and basically just went to Art Center for a brief spell, but then really learned it from assisting other photographers and then broke off. Did that up until a couple years after we had Sean, and I just was ready for not traveling so much so I could spend some more time with him and stay home with the family, and then we opened Bucks and Does basically. I think the key to our success, if you will, is that we met when we were really young. We were both really focused people and really just make sure that we can, you know, attain our goal. That's kind of what it's all about, is you set the goal, you work hard, and you obtain the goal. That's it. We have a really good team. Everybody who works for us is like family. With their help and with others who we come on as we grow, you know, I think we can just make a really good work environment. Looking at my life now, would I ever think that I would be in fashion and own a clothing store with my wife? No. If I was 21 and I was a skateboarder, I would have never thought that that would be where I am. But it's amazing. I get to work with my best friend.